Buongiorno, mi amici. My name is Chef Shaferoni, and I present to you my nuovo modello di origami. Una pizza di pepperoni veramente delizioso, and it's a flicker that flies veramente bene, così. Ti piace? You like? You want to learn to fold it? Tutti insieme andiamo a piegare. Uno, due, tre, vai!
Alright, so to fold this slice of pizza, I'm going to use a 6-inch square of commi. Let's begin colored side up and fold diagonally in half. As always, try to make really precise folds and crease sharply. Now, unfold and rotate and fold diagonally in half in this direction. Now, this is a rather complex model, so if you're new to folding, I really don't recommend folding this model because you might get really frustrated. But if you're up for the challenge, then let's continue. Now let's fold this corner to here. We're making a water bomb base. So let's turn over and fold this corner up to here. And now open the big pocket and bring the left and right sides together and flatten. And here we have the water bomb base. Let's rotate and fold in half in this direction. Now, try to keep the layers down so that they don't slide. And rotate. And now fold all four of these corners to this point. And once again, hold the layers down so that they don't slide. Or at least so that they don't slide as much. And crease that sharply. And unfold. And now let's fold this top flap up so that this edge aligns with the crease. And now we're going to squash it. So reach inside the pocket and flatten it. And now fold the raw corner up like this. And here is our first pepperoni. It's square right now, but it'll be octagonal. Let's unfold this flap and refold it so that this crease aligns with this crease. Like that. Okay, so here's our slice of pizza, and now we're going to make the second pepperoni. So let's fold the flap up so that this edge aligns with the crease. And open the pocket and squash it. And fold the corner up. All right, now we're going to temporarily hide the pepperoni by just pivoting it underneath. So it's like this. There it is. And now we're going to fold this flap up, but first let's make a guide mark. So let's fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with this edge. And we don't need to fold it all the way across. Just make a pinch mark right there. There is our pinch mark. And unfold. And now fold this flap up so that this corner touches the pinch mark. Like that. And flatten. Okay, so there we have two square pepperonis. Let's make the third. So fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with the crease. And reach in and squash it. And fold the flap up. And let's momentarily hide the pepperoni by pivoting it underneath. And now fold this corner to this corner of this pepperoni. So it's like that. Okay. Now let's start rounding the pepperonis. Well, octagonalizing them anyway. Let's fold this flap so that this edge aligns with the diagonal of the square, like that. And now fold this raw corner up to this point, right at the intersection there. And unfold this flap. Like that. So this right here is mathematically a side of the octagon. Now, we could do that to the other sides. For instance, you could fold this up here and then fold that down there, and you would have the exact other side of the octagon. But I'd say, since pepperonis don't really have to be octagonal, I mean, they're not anyway, let's just eyeball it. So fold the corner behind, estimating an octagon. And same over here. So we want to fold it about this much right here, so that these two segments are equal. And that way, all of these segments should be approximately equal. Okay, let's do the same thing on this one. And once again, I'm just going to estimate the side. So try to match it with this side right here. And try to keep this edge parallel to this edge. And fold this corner. That looks good. And this corner. And let's do the same thing with this third pepperoni. Okay, so here we have the three almost octagonal pepperonis. Let's put a crease that goes through all layers right about here. What we're trying to do is estimate the final edge of the octagon. So here and here, and connect those two with a fold. We're just pinching along there, like that. And we don't need to fold along here. This is fine, just like that. Okay, and let's do the same sort of thing for this pepperoni. So just fold it right about like that, estimating the octagon. And this one, let's continue across. Try to make it so that this edge and this edge are parallel. Okay, and unfold. Okay, now let's rotate. This is going to be the crust. Let's start out by making a little fold. We're going to fold this edge to the crease. So here goes. And turn over, and let's fold this edge to this edge. And we don't need to fold all the way across, just make a pinch mark. So the two edges align and just pinch it right about there. And unfold and turn back over and unfold here. Those were just pre-creases for later. All right, now let's unfold this flap. And now we're going to try to octagonalize these two right here. So let's start with this one. What we're going to do is make a fold that goes from this point underneath the layer to here. So we're just folding like this. Make that fold like that. And now we just pinch along the existing fold. And when we flatten it, it makes a new fold right there. And there is our octagonal pepperoni. Okay. So it's like that. And I'm going to undo that just so you see what happened. It was like this. And we just pushed here, sliding the paper underneath this pepperoni. Like that. And let's do the same thing on this one. So make this fold. And it doesn't really matter where this fold is, but might as well make it about like this so that this angle between these two edges is 45 degrees and flatten. Okay, so there we have two octagons. Now let's bring this flap back down. And now we're going to adjust it. So instead of like this, we want this flap to go underneath here. That'll just kind of hold it down so that it'll fly better. And it'll also bring it off this side. So about like this. If you want, you could pivot it on this point right here. So it's like that. Okay, and now let's fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with this crease. No, actually, let's fold it up so that this edge is almost up to this edge. So it's like that. And now unfold this flap. And now we're going to squash this flap. So kind of lift it up and squash it. And when we squash it, we want this crease to land on this edge. So it's like that. And now refold it and stick it under. Like that. And there is our third octagon. Oh, this one keeps on getting hidden. Okay. Now let's continue with the crust. So now what we're going to do is, well, we should have a little crease right here. That was when we made that pinch. Let's fold along that crease, but we're just kind of pivoting the paper. I'm going to zoom in so you see this a little bit better. We want to fold on the crease and just pleat the top layers like this and flatten it so that this edge is parallel to this crease right here. So it's like that. And now let's fold this behind like that. And now we're going to make another sort of pleat right on this edge. We just pleat it like this. This time we want it to pleat so that this edge and this edge align. So it's like that. And now let's pull this behind. So we got our crust like this. And this pepperoni wants to hide always. Now we're going to fold this edge. We're going to fold this edge in a little bit, just about a millimeter, as small as you can so that you still grab onto all of the layers. This can be the thickness of the pizza. And it can also help for the flickers so that these pockets don't pick up air as the pizza flies. Okay, and let's unfold it. And let's fold this edge similarly, just a little bit. Just enough to close off those pockets. Or if you want a deep dish pizza, you could fold it up a whole bunch more. But no, we're gonna have a thin slice so that it slices through the air. Okay, that's pretty good. And now unfold here. Oops, make sure that this crease is really sharp. Now unfold here. And now we're going to fold this flap in right on the intersection. Gosh, this is so small, I can't do this. Right on the intersection of the two creases. So it's like this. If you want, you can turn it over and fold it. And we want this crease to line up with this crease, and this crease to line up with this crease. So it's like that. And now unfold it, and let's reverse fold. So open here, and stick this in right on the existing crease, like that. And let's fold the raw edges and fold this side like that. Zoom out. And here we got our pizza. Now, you can just kind of shape it to taste. If you want it to be like a static model that doesn't fly well, then I'd recommend just folding this out so that it looks like the pizza has some thickness. But I think it'll fly better if you really make that fold sharp. So that's what I'm gonna do. Oh, and also if you want it to be a static model, you can kind of shape the crust to taste. To taste, yeah. This is tasty pizza if you're a silverfish. Okay, so there you have it, the pizza. And I'm gonna flatten this because I want it to fly. Let's see how this thing flies.
E adesso andiamo a volare. Wait, you don't want me to speak Italian anymore? Okay, fine. Well, so to fly this thing, what you wanna do is hold it like this and just hit it right at the corner so that it spins around like this. And the idea is you want this to be as flat as possible so that it's the most aerodynamic, and you want to have the flaps flattened like that. And here goes. So just gonna hit it out of my hands, try to make it spin as much as you can, and give it a good flick. Oh yeah. Mm-hmm.
All right, well, there you have it. I hope you guys enjoyed folding this model, and I'll see you guys later. Ciao. And now, bon appetit.
Delizioso. Delizioso.